Namaste.
Namaste.
Let's get some energy here. Namaste.
Namaste.
Should I speak in English or Hindi?
English.
I remember he has told me I am going to reveal something, there is no revelation. Please don't expect anything dramatic today, I am just going to talk my heart out to you. I remember 2010, I think all of us remember. Media used to be full of stories of the Commonwealth game corruption, of the coal corruption, the 2G corruption. We used to be tired of this dynastic rule in which a Gandhi family would be the only one who would inherit the kingdom. There was unrest. We were all very apathetic. Kuch nahi hoga is desh ka. 2010 end, if somebody had told me this country will change, I would have laughed at it. Kuch nahi badalne wala is desh. But in 2011, Arvind came to me and told me, Mayank, मैंने एक बिल बनाया है. मैं प्रशांत भूषण, शांति भूषण और संतोष हेगड़े ने एक बिल बनाया है, जन लोकपाल, जिससे करप्शन काफी कम हो सकता है. फॉर 42 इयर्स दिस हैज नॉट बीन पास्ड. इट्स टाइम वी डिड अ मूवमेंट. विल यू प्लीज ज्वाइन मी. अर्लियर आई हैड वर्क विद अन्ना फॉर द राइट टू इन्फॉर्मेशन बिल एक्सेट्रा. आई फेल्ट इट वॉज अ मोमेंटस टाइम in the history of this nation, then something could be done. So, ek taraf se there was cynicism ke kuch nahi hoga. Okay, I remember we tried to have mobilization, we tried to have meeting on various issues of national importance, but nothing happened. 50 people would not gather, you had to send SMS to everyone. Are aa raha hai ke nahi aa raha hai, aa raha hai ke nahi aa raha hai. Nahi, aaj mera mausi ke jija ka, chacha ka, ladki ka shaadi hai, toh main nahi aa sakta. So, in a way, there was this fear. I remember the first meeting we did at Azad Maidan, there were 20 people. But suddenly, I suggested to Arvind, why don't you include Anna? Anna would be a good person to have, to lead this movement. And suddenly it just took, it took its own momentum. I remember a message nahi gaya, phat, kahan kahan se, kaise kaise log aa jate. Suddenly we had touched some nerve. This country had touched a nerve. Jo pura desh tamas mein tha, in apathy, in cynicism, suddenly became angry. Bharat Mata ki jai, Vande Mataram, road ke upar aa rahe the. So what was happening was, there was a change in consciousness. People did not realize, why are we going like this? What is driving us? Why are we watching television channels for 24 hours? And I know people who used to watch it the whole night, not sleep. There was some shift in consciousness that happened. There was passion. There was idealism. There was romanticism. There was a chance that something will happen to this country. And something did. देश बदल गया? आई डोंट थिंक सो. देश पूरा बदल जाएगा जैसा नरेंद्र मोदी ने कहा या अरविंद केजरीवाल ने कहा? आई डोंट थिंक सो. पर लोगों की मानसिकता बदल रही है. पीपल हैव स्टार्टेड थिंकिंग डिफरेंटली. पीपल हु डिड नॉट हैव द गट्स हैव स्टार्टेड स्टैंडिंग अप. आज आप मुंबई के अंदर एक SRA का प्रोजेक्ट ऐसा नहीं होगा जहां के वहां के लोग RTI करके लड़ते ना हो. थिंग्स हैव चेंज ड्रामेटिकली. People have become strong, they have become bold, they have become daring. And that, I think, is the real change that has taken place. The other important thing I always keep on asking, which is the biggest problem of India? Somebody would say poverty, somebody would say illiteracy, somebody would say injustice, somebody would say reservation. But the biggest problem in this country has always been leadership. We have never got a good leader, whether you go in business, whether you go in politics, whether you go in spiritual, whatever subject you get, you look at people, you feel wonderful leadership, the closer you get, you start seeing, oh my God, this has feet of clay. Don't you think so? That is the tragedy of this country. And this country has been progressing. People, corporates have been growing crazily. We were afraid of being swamped by multinationals. Today we are in the possibilities of swamping other countries with our strengths. Our spiritual leaders are going and talking about the Indian knowledge system, about various things, and people are following, more and more people are following the thought process that came from India, the Indian knowledge system, the yoga, the medicine, the healing, the worldview. Things have started changing. But also, very importantly, I must say, we must make a distinction. While there were problems that were happening within the country, in a geopolitical spectrum, India was growing, as it is growing even now. India is becoming more and more relevant to this country, to this world. But within this, our internal leadership, our internal politics was not able to keep pace with it. So what we did was, and then it wasn't as if we were the first people to talk about principled politics. There have been many, many attempts before. But there has always been a gap between viability and principles. People did fight on principles, but there was no chance of their winning. Elections were determined by money, muscles and divisive agenda. An honest party with check payment, with official money, without using politics of Hindu, Muslim, Marathi, non-Marathi, upper caste, lower caste, had no chance of victory. Aam Aadmi Party, once it was created, is the first example in India in the 68 years which said that it is possible to win while using the correct principles. So this is an experiment which is very crucial. I don't know how much Aam Aadmi Party will go, what will what extent, whether it will become the ruling party of this country, whether it will be determined or will stay in one or two states or what, I don't know. I don't know the future. But it has led the way for others to come in and say, yes, it's possible. It's possible to come to this country to fight elections and win without using all the devious methods that the other political parties use. But having said that, I must tell you a couple of things which are bothering me for some days. Narendra Modi came with great expectations, great hopes. He swept the country. But today, all those people who had banked on Narendra Modi are disillusioned, aren't they? ये बोलता बहुत है, करता कुछ नहीं है, बातें बड़ी-बड़ी है, लेक्चरबाजी करता है, पूरी वर्ल्ड में घूमता है. I think he is doing what best he can. There are problems, there are issues. अब दिल्ली में जाओ तो दिल्ली में मैं सबको मिलता हूँ. बोले अरविंद केजरीवाल आया, हमको लगा हमारा पूरा जिंदगी बदल जाएगा, लेकिन कुछ फर्क नहीं है. वही का वही करप्शन, वही का वही ब्यूरोक्रेसी, वही का वही करप्शन. सो रियली व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इज दिस कंट्री इज सो वास्ट, दिस कंट्री इज सो कॉम्प्लेक्स, दिस कंट्री इज रिवन विद डिवाइसिव एजेंडास, दिस कंट्री इज अ ब्रोकन अप कंट्री. Big changes will never take place. And if you come to power with big hopes and expectations, in 1 year, people will start getting disillusioned. And I'm going to talk to you about what we are doing in Delhi. And when you hear me, you will find, my God, is it possible for a government to do so much with such wonderful outputs? But you'll talk to the person on the street, he is very unhappy. That's because this country will never grow at the pace we are expecting it to grow. It will always be a Hindu rate of growth. The economy may grow at maybe 7%, 8%. But the changes that are going to take place in the life of a common man is going to take a long, long time. And it's going to be very slow. It's like building a muscle. You have to keep on working, working, working if you want to build muscles. It cannot happen overnight. So, Let me just quickly tell you what happens in Delhi. Not that it's because my party and that I want to talk about it, but something very interesting is happening. We thought that there will be a change in political culture. I am not sure how much it has changed. But we were also wanting to have a governance change in this country. And I must give you four quick points that a change will take place in four things: material, human, natural and social. So what has changed in Delhi? In the first quarter, the VAT collection increased by 700 crores in a quarter. There were no raids, no inspector raj. Businessmen were called and said, you give your taxes properly, we will ensure that nobody raids you, nobody harasses you. We will try and streamline all taxes, all systems, so that you can do your business at peace. Finally, the growth of the country happens through its people, not through its government. A government is only a facilitator to make that happen. Electricity, you know, the prices have come down by 50% for the poorest of the poor. And that is our focus. How the poor people, they need good governance the first. There was an audit that was announced when first Aam Aadmi Party came to power in 28 seats. Now that audit report has come which says ke 8000 crore ka gabla kiya hai Reliance. Now that money by which they had gold-plated all their investments and all their things is now getting exposed, and that will have an impact on the total. So the subsidy which has been given for electricity will soon be taken away because overall electricity prices will come. Water is being given free to the people. People say, "Arey, subsidy deta hai, subsidy wala." Do you know how much the other governments are giving subsidy? What we are giving is peanuts. The earlier government gave Delhi golf course land at a price which took away 5,000 crores from Delhi. Total our subsidy is less than 400 crores. The advertising budget of the previous government and today's government is less by more than 500 crores. The security expenses that they used to make with all those VIP security has reduced dramatically. So all that money is being saved and given to the poor. Why are we having a problem? Electricity companies have been told that every hour of electricity that you don't give, you will have to pay penalty. So now there are very few electricity cuts are happening now because they are being penalized very heavily if they give a power cut at all. Water tankers have been put, GPS has been put, so we know where the water tankers are going, what is happening. Meters are read by self and not by somebody coming. But what is most important, I think, is what has happened to human aspect of governance. I don't know.